Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Alex Gallo, and I'm the president of ISM's Fine Arts Council, as well as a member of the High School Orchestra. The FAC works to connect the various arts clubs and honor societies at ISM while also supporting the school's Fine and Performing Arts program. Part of this support includes the ushers who are present at today's concert. Please feel free to contact them if you do need any assistance. Part of their task this evening is to ensure that you please do not record today, as we do have professional photographers and videographers at the event. The video of the concert will be available on the official ISM YouTube channel on Thursday. So with that, I do please ask you to turn off your phones for the duration of the concert so as to not disturb anyone, and so that we can experience the beautiful magic that the music that will be played today will experience. Thank you, and now I'd like to introduce ISM's Fine and Performing Arts Director, Ms. Marcia Hillman.
Thank you, Alex, and thank you to the Fine Arts Council for what they do. It's my pleasure to welcome you here today for our second of three concerts that we do at the end of semester one. These are called the ALLS concerts, and the whole purpose of them is to give you a sense of the vertical articulation, what happens as you go through the school, and how the students grow as musicians throughout our program. So we get to see these wonderful students here, who are, for some of you, it's your first time playing a strings concert on the FAT. It used to be the Little Theatre, and now we've graduated, and we're sitting here. Bows up if it's your first time on the FAT stage for a strings concert. Okay, can we put our hands together for these wonderful students? You'll get to see these amazing people, and at the other end, so the high schoolers are sitting up there at the moment, and we'll come down and have their moment at some point during the show. You'll get to see what 8 years of a program at ISM looks like and how these students will grow. Although some of these people are already totally amazing, and we could put them with a high schooler now and they would blow the socks off them. So, anyhow, just before we begin the actual concert, I want to remind you of other things that are happening at ISM in the arts world. Just as you walked in, you would have seen a wonderful art show that just opened at 3 p.m. today, so you're the first sort of audience group to come in and see that. That is from the middle school students and also some high school students from the Intro and Explore program, so roughly grade 9, 10-ish students from the high school. So please take the time as you're going in and out to check that out. But if you haven't got time today, that'll be up till December 8th to enjoy. Next week, after we've had the wonderful strings concert, some of you will probably want to come back and check out our band concert, which is the middle school, high school band concert. That is next week on Wednesday evening on the 29th at 5:30. So please come along next week to enjoy that as well. Then there's an exciting day, and if you're new to ISM, it's one of the best days of the year, I would say. It's Filipiniana, and it's December 1st this year. The students have assemblies where they get to celebrate all of all the wonderful cultural performances that are put on by the various students. But for everybody who is in the ISM community, there'll be wonderful food stalls, and the middle schoolers will be doing all sorts of Filipino kind of inspired activities. So there will be lots seeing around campus. So just come to campus on December 1st and be prepared to enjoy that occasion. And then grade 2 concert is in here on December 7th, so if which is the ES's first big concert to come in. It's from their music program, and it's a lot of choir singing. And so please come along to those events. The program, Alex said that, you know, we'd like you to switch off your phones, obviously. Obviously, if you want to be using the program, just put it onto airplane mode. The program is a QR code that's outside, so if you missed it, you can grab that on the way out and enjoy that. And then the last thing I want to plug before we I pass over to our wonderful music directors is the fact that in March we will be hosting ISIS Dance Drama Tech, which is a wonderful celebration where we're going to host all the ISIS schools from the other 5 ISIS schools. They will bring drama with them. 6 pieces of theatre and 6 original dances, and you'll get to come and you're invited to come and watch all of those. Part of that hosting duty is that we are looking for housing families, and I've put the hosting form up last week on the arts website, so I'd really appreciate people finding their way to helping us out. While they're away, our music group will be overseas and our debate and forensics people will be overseas, so there'll be a lot of empty beds with those students anyway. So please, there's lots going on in the arts at ISM. I really, really hope that you can come and enjoy some, if not all, of those events. I'm now going to pass over to our middle school strings teacher, who is Miss Pamela Arrieta. And I'd like to say a big thanks to her particularly. She has brought along with her today some wonderful professional musicians to work with the students. She has got all her wonderful contacts together, and she is making this a wonderful experience. And so her and JC, the high school and also middle school strings teacher, have got a lot in store for you, and she'll talk about that now. Thank you so much, Pam.
Thanks, Marsha. Good afternoon, everybody. We have been anticipating this event for months, and we are thrilled that you're all finally here today. So on behalf of the string student body, Mr. Hoya, who is our high school strings director, Ms. Ida Maximbol, who is our strings teacher assistant, it is my great pleasure to welcome you to our All Strings concert. Now, for some of you who have been with us for some time, or should I say, for some years now, you know that this event is not just about the performances of the students. It's about the process. It's about their accomplishments. It's about the linear journey of growth that they all share together. And so, for this concert, you will be reminded that every virtuoso was once a beginner. And same is true as with every renowned artist who have started with a blank canvas, or a great athlete who have begun by strengthening their stamina. Now, our more experienced students in high school will remind us that greatness is attainable through sustained commitment, resilience, hard work, and most especially when they learn how to enjoy the process. For our young beginners and intermediate students in middle school, tonight is an opportunity for them to glimpse into the future. A future where their resilience, hard work, and commitment will enable them to accomplish and enjoy the extraordinary heights of music making. Now, the path ahead may seem challenging, and it will always be challenging, but every note that they practice is a step closer to the musician they dream of being. So for tonight, we are all in for a treat as we have some spectacular elementary string players as well as some professional guest musicians who have volunteered to join us on stage to show their support to our students and to our music program. Let us show our appreciation as I acknowledge them at the end of every segment of our performance. Now, before we finally embark to this concert, I believe it is worth highlighting the incredible progress of the cello and bass group who will be performing the opening piece for tonight. They have started for just a year or a little bit more than two. And just to let you know of this, I'm going to ask this group right over here, who among you, raise your bow, if you have started just last year. Who among you? Thank you. How about the students who have started for just a little bit more than 2 years now? And so, this rare species group, whose often role in the string ensemble is to play the accompaniment part, will enchant us with their deep, gently dark, and bold tone by performing one of the most popular musicals, which is entitled The Phantom of the Opera. And now, we're ready to begin. Enjoy the concert. Thank you.
and I would always hear the violin. So I found out that I could, there was a chance for me to play the violin in middle school. And now I feel like whenever I want to feel relaxed, I have my own way of expressing music that will make me feel relaxed.
What inspired me to play the violin is I always thought when I heard the sound of a strings instrument, I always thought it was a very calming and happy sound. And I wondered, like, what if I could make such a calming and soothing sound myself?
Well, I was inspired by this show called Wednesday. She played the cello and I loved the music from it. And I also wanted to do something different for my parents because they played in band and they played the clarinet. And I wanted a different kind of music to play.
My emotions was like, I was very excited to play it and I felt like this was like a dream come true.
It was the first time I actually saw my instrument was when I was trying to see which instrument I wanted to do. And as soon as I played one note on the cello, I knew it was my instrument. I knew it was gonna be my instrument. And all these emotions of like happiness and like love, the instrument rushed to me.
When I first saw my cello, I was like super, 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 super excited. But my emotion when I played the cello, I was disappointed because we couldn't use our bow at first. We could just go.
I'm really happy that I have learned my posture. I'm also happy that I have some friends around me that help me, especially with my pinky. And I'm really appreciated for having this violin. I have a chance.
Probably like my first assessment in cello ever. Cause like when I completed it, I just wanted to do more and more.
I'm just very proud of myself for learning to play at least two songs, like Ode to Joy or Jingle Bells, because I first thought it was very complicated, but then once I finished, I was very proud of myself.
I feel like I'm really happy I can show my skills that I have learned, share them with my parents so they can be proud of me. And I also want to make Miss Pam really proud and see that she has taught us a lot of great stuff and that I appreciate her.
I'm a little bit nervous, but hearing us play as an ensemble, I'm really excited to see what we can do on the stage.
I'm super excited because you, like my parents, other friends' parents are going to see how like we progressed and like how we turned like just hearing us practice and like the afternoon to like actually practicing on stage in a big auditorium.
Thank you.
because, like, first in the pandemic, I didn't play with, like, other people. I just played on my own, my teacher. So it was kind of hard adjusting. But after a while, I became comfortable with playing as an ensemble than playing alone.
Adjusting playing as an ensemble was at first challenging because I wasn't used to it. But after a while, it became natural because everyone was improving and it made good success.
Playing as an ensemble definitely has its ups and downs. When we play together, sometimes it sounds like beautiful harmony, but sometimes sometimes it can be a bit stressful because there can be different timings, which can be a little bit annoying.
Like, this is an environment where we can all make mistakes, but we learn from our mistakes. So I wouldn't be mad at them, but give them advice.
Sometimes my friend just asks me to check in with me. So I feel really so good because I feel like they're respecting me. And I also sometimes want to ask my friends to give an advice.
I support them by helping them with parts that they need help on, and I give them encouragement when they need it.
I chose to continue learning this because it is just very, very fun to me, because at first I chose this instrument and then it was like, oh, I don't really like to do this anymore. My sound is so, why can't I just sound like the rest? And then I kind of got used to it and I was able to play better.
Because a lot of people are moving from music to eye design, and I thought that I would not quit as a bass because it was fun with Miss Pam and I worked hard. Do I want to stop now?
Well, I kind of had faith in my instrument, and when I started playing the violin, I was really, really excited too. And as time progressed, I started having more fun playing the violin.
My favorite piece is Presto because it's a very classical piece, and there are very various parts in the piece that like make you feel like you're in a different zone.
Like, not like others, I really like Baby Shark because it's so joyful and creative, and also I like pop music than classic music, and so I really like that song. And since I'm the harmony second violin, sometimes when I feel like, when I play it alone, then I feel like, oh, I'm so bad at this. But when I play with together and play this Baby Shark, then I get that I'm very enjoying it.
I like Baby Shark because this kind of version is arranged and it's like in the middle of it. It's not really the exact type of Baby Shark. It's like they modified it a bit, which makes it sound really nice.
It has to be Presto because of the classical element of music that it has. When I hear it the first time, I immediately voted for it because it sounded like heaven.
Thank you. I've learned to kind of look at problems with a kind of eye that I've kind of developed at strings class. I think that I've also have been trying to kind of use it outside of school as well.
It has taught me that I have to constantly do something in order to remember it and improve. I feel that learning my instrument has taught me how unaware some people can be of the music community. Although they listen to classical music, I think that they don't truly understand how it is to play a classical instrument and the efforts that it takes.
I think that consistency has definitely been one challenge that I've been facing, as I'm pretty overtaxed. I do a lot of different stuff, so I think committing and kind of to practice and get better with my violin has been something I've definitely been trying to work on. I think in the future I'll continue to try and work towards that goal.
I think one big challenge for me was to continuously practice. It's because sometimes we have a lot of assignments, assessments, and other activities. So it was sometimes challenging to create time to practice.
I think the most challenging moments is when I play with myself, just myself. I think it's extremely difficult for me because I have no one or no other sound to guide me through the piece or the skill I'm trying to learn.
I think that the first time I've played in such like a huge ensemble playing the same song, I felt that was like a really like fun new experience that like honestly I really enjoyed. It was like so interesting to see like how different people played and practiced, and I really just want to try and get better so that I can kind of play with those people.
The most thing I really enjoy is playing as an ensemble and strings class. There's many challenging things to play together. However, it really feels like we are bonding together and trying to work hard to achieve a goal.
My favorite moment is when I walk into class and I'm super prepared. I love sitting down next to my seat partner and opening the music sheet. When we start playing as an ensemble, I feel as if all the notes start to come together and I can play freely and clearly.
As a larger ensemble, it's hard to get everyone to blend in with the ensemble when playing, but I have a feeling it's a good experience when playing with a larger ensemble because you get to feel the diversity of the group.
I really like how there's so much things that you can really learn from other people because there are people from various degrees, various levels, and of course there are people who are much, much better than me, but I think it's really fun and interesting how everyone's super supportive, everyone helps one another. I think that there's a lot to be learned from them. It's like, and I really enjoy it. Thank you.
I feel that playing in a larger ensemble, you have to learn skills such as listening and adapting. I think some challenges are blending your sound with others. And I think something I like about it is when you finally get it. So the final sound is just amazing, and it's the most wonderful feeling. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
chose to be a part of the Virtuosi group because I wanted a selective chance to represent ISM strings. I wanted to continue from last year to push myself to experience new techniques and skills and meet new people and challenge myself out of my comfort zone.
I chose to be part of Virtuosi to hopefully challenge me more and make me a more advanced player. And also because everybody in Virtuosi wants to be there and wants to grow, so I thought that I could learn a lot from that environment.
It's something that I really wanted to do. I feel really happy that I'm able to go to all these rehearsals because then I can spend more time playing my instrument and just having fun with others.
I feel great about making extra time for Virtuosi because I can stay with my Virtuosi group more. And
sometimes I need to adjust my schedule. However, I feel really proud and happy to join the Virtuosi group where I can experience new things which I cannot in strings class.
I do love participating in strings class, but being with Virtuosi makes me feel like I'm in a more concentrated orchestra of passionate musicians.
I feel like in Virtuosi, you get to express yourself more because you have more control over what you play and how you play it. So in strings class, the teacher might give you some dynamics or some bowing suggestions, but in Virtuosi, you kind of have partial control over that. You can suggest like, I think a bow is better here, or about the intonation, you can make some comments that you don't want to make in strings class.
Even though maybe the bar is a little higher for Virtuosi, it also feels like it's a little more relaxed because it's kind of an extra thing and everybody's like really comfortable there. So.
I'm very proud of being a part of Virtuosi group, working together with people who I usually don't, people from other grades, to achieve a goal together.
I'm really proud to represent this group because there's a lot of different kinds of musicians from everywhere around the world. And I mean, that's the same for ISM, but it's really cool to find people from everywhere with so many different like cultures and ideas that we all like share one same thing, which is like the passion for music. So it's always nice to see how music can like unite people and kind of just see where we go with it.
I'm proud to be in this group because I can practice more and I can participate like more in strings. And I love to play strings and this is the best group to be in.
Thank you. I'm proud of what we have achieved sort of more holistically as an entire group because the progress feels really fast. We've only been playing our piece for about a month now, but it's sounding really great, so I'm excited to perform.
My name is Amelie. I'm in grade 9 and I play violin in high school orchestra. It's just as an extracurricular. And I personally got into violin because my whole mother's side of the family is just really into the musician stuff, and I just am part of that. So I just persevere on because a lot of my friends have helped me go through this and made me want to play violin even more. So just keep on.
Hi, my name's Sabino, and I'm a first violinist in concert strings. All depends on what level you want to be at, but personally, it's not too much of a time commitment. You can practice for around like 30 minutes a day, and it's not always about practicing more, but also practicing smarter. You know, do you practice with a metronome? Do you really take the time to familiarize yourself with the pieces you're playing? And those are the kinds of questions that you need to have answered rather than just...
Hi, my name is Itas. I'm in concert strings and I play the violin. I think key insights that I've taken away from strings class are definitely that you have to definitely put in the work into strings class. You have to practice if you want to play on that level. Strings class, of course, the commitment that you put depends on you.
Hi, my name is Alex, and I play the violin in orchestra. In my time at ISM, I went through the concert strings to orchestra progression, and they were both very interesting, very captivating experiences. Like in concert strings, you could really get down and focus on making sure that you're playing is very consistent, sounds very well. And then in orchestra, you're focusing more on developing maybe the more emotional side of the piece and making sure that the audience can kind of feel the experience like as you're playing.
Hi, my name is Yuma. I'm in 10th grade and I play the violin in orchestra class. I think that orchestra class is an amazing place. It's very positive and everyone's really friendly to each other. I think at times it can be taxing in terms of like workload. And I say workload because it's not really like a learning class, it's more of like a physical class. And it's demanding at times, but it's really fun, it's worth it, it's rewarding. And everything that you do, the amount of work you put in is almost directly reflected in the performance that you're able to put on at the end. So I think that it is an amazing experience.
Good evening. The success of our program wouldn't be possible without the support of some important person. And we would like to give our sincerest appreciation to each and every one of you. From our ISM administration, our musician friends and guest artists, supervising volunteer teachers, people who work behind the scenes, our FAT tech, Caleb, video and audio recording, Sir Rain, our esteemed service desk and security office, Marcia Hillman, Carrie Greve, Dennis Legdameo, our music teachers, parents, guests, and our energetic students, thank you. Thank you so much. Can we give our round of applause one more time? Okay, I think we are ready for the high school. So we are playing 4 pieces tonight, and I hope you like it.
Perspectives and Equity. Tsunayama. Traditional Japanese folk songs captivate listeners with their serene and melancholic melodies. The artistry behind this masterpiece has skillfully combined the talents of concert strings, creating a harmonious blend of musical brilliance. The solo parts, a result of blind auditions, showcase the student artist's commitment to fairness and excellence. The selection process was truly democratic, with the consensus of the entire class making a significant impact on the whole ensemble. Legato articulation cannot be overstated, as it adds a seamless flow to this enchanting performance. Across this spectrum, student artists believed that music would enable them to transcend national boundaries and make connections across cultures. prowess and figurations. M to the third power. Driven by notions of shared ideas, student artists continue to examine the role of musical pulse in an increasingly complex musical environment. This masterpiece is designed to captivate students with its regular and compound meter, while emphasizing the importance of bowing technique and accentuation. By mastering the steady pulse of this music, students have valuable bowing techniques that will equip them in their musical journey. Student artists behind this masterpiece have skillfully created a unique and engaging performance piece. With a commitment to utilizing effective practice tools, the success of this work will be ironed out by this performance. Succession and openness. Simple symphony, first movement. As the composition was established as a gift to Benjamin Britten's viola teacher, student artists' use of marcato bowing articulation will polish the beauty of this work. Despite the factor of time needed to reach this level, selected advanced MS and HS strings benefited from their highest practice ethics, achieving a technically demanding masterpiece. Student artists' stylistic approaches varied according to their strategies and tedious chamber music environment. Ownership and Identity. Simple Symphony, Fourth Movement. Whether this music should aspire to be an aesthetic musical achievement or a form of agitation for change, this composition led the student artists to have a deep self-awareness and insightful music recognition. As like-minded students came together to form this performance, their instrument voices grew stronger in many places of Britain's composition. The gigantic fortissimos and the whispery pianissimos made the dynamic range of their playing environment complex.
Thank you so much. That concludes our concert for tonight. Just before we go, I would like to bring some students, would like to bring some flowers out that the parents of the strings have brought for the wonderful teachers. Can we put our hands together for Mr. Hoyer, Miss Ida, and Miss Pam? Could you bring out the flowers and hand them out to people? Miss Ida is over at the back there. And we'll find Miss Pam wherever she is hiding in the building, hopefully soon. Thank you so much for supporting your child's journey. I hope you got a sense of the program can take you at ISM, right from Jingle Bells through to our wonderful concertos. Please join us again next week for the band concert, or if you don't come for that and you're more of a strings person, look out for next in February, where we do our ISS previews, where you'll get another taste of strings music on this stage. Goodbye, and thank you so much for coming. Good night.